the boys after the war. We had these service canteens. And this is called Canteen Love. I thought you'd like to know as how I've got off at last. At least it's almost as good as certain. But I've had hopes before and they've been dashed. But this time, I believe romance has come to me. I put it down to me new teeth, plastic and only 6 more instalments to pay. It all started with Mrs. Thompson asking me to help out at the territorial canteen. I said no at first, thinking of all the washing up and me fallen arches. But when she said it's for the soldiers, I thought to myself, Lily, I thought it's a person's duty to help England, and wild horses won't stop me from doing the same. So I had a perm and bandaged up me in steps and signed on. And believe me or believe me not, the boys took to me right from the start. They calls me Ippo. I expect it's short for Ippiparay. Mind you, there ain't much room behind the counter, and the things I knock off the back shelf, well, you wouldn't believe me. But I must tell you about it, mustn't I? It was last Tuesday week, baked beans night it was. I was just dusting off these bristles when up comes a bully of a sergeant, brings back his plate of baked beans, says it was the same what he brought back the night before. Well, I was telling him what he could do with his plate of baked beans, and he was telling me who my mother and father was. When up comes this little bloke, I'd noticed him before, leaning on the slab cake in the corner, and he comes up and he says brisk-like, Don't take no notice of the rough soldier, miss, and give me a cup of coffee or a key doorstep. Well, I could see he was interested in me even then. And every evening when he comes in, I give him a look. And every now and again, he looks back. At least I think it's me he's looking at, but one of his eyes is sort of swiveling. And then one day I put on me new blue satin blouse, and he comes up and he leads over the counter and he says, oh, it ain't true. Well, I didn't like to act too eager, as it doesn't do, but I gives him extra sugar and I stirs it for him. And then one day I read his tea leaves and I tell him I can see wedding bells as clear as anything. Oh, put me off my work so that I was putting sugar on the fish cakes and gravy on the jam tarts. And Miss Mason, who's the boss of the counter, or likes to think she is, says to me, Lily Brown, if I couldn't think that you are as stupid as you look, I wouldn't believe it. But I never back answered her. She's never had no romance like me. They say she even counts the tea leaves. Oh, I mustn't be cracking here. I'm off after I've washed up 100,000 cups. And tonight, I think things will clinch it. I says to him, tea time, I says, I'm off at 9. And he says, off where? And I says, off duty. And he said, oh. And I says to him, I think I go over the fields, you know. And he says, well, give my love to the bull. I know what he means, and I'll be very surprised if I don't find him waiting outside for me, with love just shining out of his one good eye. Ta-da!
Thank you, Shirley. You're going to be willing to answer questions and